Hi everyone, this is another video from last year that I am redoing with narration instead of music. So that has been a request by many of you. No music, so I'm going to talk you through this one. It looks very difficult, but trust me, it's not. None of my ornaments are difficult. So we are going to use all these different colors, and of course our blush. I am working on a sheet of paper, which helps you with the size of the ornament. If you go off the paper, you know you're too big. We're going to start with rolling white clay into a rounded triangle. And now the smaller, narrow end will be the bottom of the owl. This owl is going to be about, I would say, about 3 inches, maybe not quite 3 inches tall. This is his body. Oh, I'm leaving you hanging there. Now, to make the feathers, I'm using the cap of a Sharpie pen. You can use a drinking straw, which I switched to because this didn't quite come out the way I liked. But as you can see, you can use anything like this shape to do the feathers. And I redid this because it just didn't look right. I think it may have been a little too thick. I think the drinking straw was a little thinner. At some point, I will show you where I redid it. I should have cut this part out, but I wanted to show you that you can use different things, and if you don't like it, just start over. And I'm going, now that I have a little time here, I'm going to do this with all the videos that have music. I'm going to redo all of them. Yeah, see, I don't know what I was thinking there, but I have to redo the entire body. I probably didn't have this part in the video I did last year with the music, but that's all right. I took it out. I don't remember. So let's start all over again. And yes, this is thinner and much easier to use than the Sharpie cap. And while we are doing this, as I said, I'm going to be redoing all the videos with music in it. It's not the best music, but you know, you have to be careful with music because of copyright. So you can only use music that you are allowed to use. So there wasn't that big a choice when I was making ornaments. Now, YouTube now has music that we can use for free, but I haven't really gone through it yet and see if there's anything that sounds interesting, but you have all made it pretty loud and clear, have told me, do the narration, no music. So I'm switching to no music. Now you see that worked much, much better. Now the brown is going to be the branch that the owl is sitting on. And I'm going to show you how to do that on the white paper. It'll show up a little better. Just roll a log because we're making a branch. And then I use the needle tool to just texture it, give it some texture to make it look woodsy, woody, whatever. And as you can see, very easy, nothing difficult about this. fell off. But there you can see how it looks like a branch or a piece of wood. And don't make it go straight across. Give it a little movement there. There we go. Make sure you press it on to the bottom of your owl's body. And I don't want you to flatten any of these things. Don't make anything flat. And we're going to do some teardrop shapes for his talons. And I am using black clay. And yeah, he could have orange talons. But I decided to go with a black. And most of this is going to be covered by the feathers on his legs, but you still want to put it on there. There's three for each leg. Now, my aunt collects owls. She has quite a collection. And her daughter collected eagles and anything Americana, anything red, white, and blue. And my sister went to Bryn Mawr College, and they had the three eagles. So we're going to do his quote-unquote ruffles. Very easy, just roll out some white clay, put it on. I hope I'm speaking loud enough. Now I'm using the knitting needle to just texture the ruffles, because you want to make it look like feathers. Feathery. And for his wings, instead of making one big wing, I'm going to layer three tapered triangles on each side. And I like the way that looks. You know, we're not going for realism here, although he looks pretty real, but we just want him to look like an owl, but we're not doing realistic looking animals or birds. Now, if you make this one to sell, I would probably ask in the $15 range for him, because he does take a little longer. Now this is just the snow on the branch, and all I'm doing is putting a little snake of white on there and then pulling it down with my finger to make it look like it's kind of melting down. Very simple, very easy. In a later video, if you like owls, I'm going to be doing a steampunk owl. That's a fun one too. Now here I'm just making a base for his head, so we have somewhere to put his head. See, so it sticks on a little bit better. We always want to make sure that everything is sticking together and won't fall apart. And I know that I've said this before, make sure your clay is very well conditioned. Don't just take it out of the package and smoosh it up and go. Condition it. Now we're going to roll a ball for the head. And I'm just kind of pinching out. I like to call them his ears, but we know they're not ears. I know they're not ears, but this is just kind of how their feathers go. I know it looks like a cat head, but no. At least I don't think those are his ears. I don't know. Maybe they are. I'm going to have to look that up too. I never thought about that. Where are the ears of the birds? I did the eagle, where are his ears? Now what I'm doing here, making his little feathers in his face, I took the straw and just kind of pinched it together to make the smaller indentations, and they're not as big as on his body. I hope you can see how I pressed the straw together. I do have a video on how to price the ornaments. This one's a little more work. I would price them a little higher, as I said. Now, I don't think you can do 20 of these in an hour, maybe 5. So as you can see, I'm just adding that there to blend his head into his body. Because, you know, when you look at an owl, he doesn't really look like he has a neck. His body just kind of, it's like it's all one piece on most owls. Some owls, not so much, but. And we're also going to be doing a steampunk cat. And I think that's going to be the next video that I'm going to do. Is I'm going to show you different ways to do a cat. And it's going to be one body. All right, let's get back to our owl. You see how the little feathers? They're smaller than on the body. Now, this is the end of the cap of the Sharpie pen, and it makes a really cool indentation, as you can see. Almost does the work for you. But you don't have to worry about the inner indentation if you don't have a Sharpie pen. You can use any little round object. And this is where my camera died. But I didn't really do that much. I just made the indentations. The hole's a little bigger in the middle. I put in some light blue clay and pressed it down with the end of my paintbrush. And then I put in a little bit darker clay, little round balls of the little darker clay for the eyes. Pressed them in a little bit. As you can see, so we're caught up. There wasn't that much lost. Then I put in even a little bit more. I think this is white. Nope, it's an even lighter blue. So I did light blue, darker blue, and then the light blue again. And you can make it any color. Because I'm sure the white owls have different color eyes than this. I just like the color combination. The owl is the exception to the deer caught in the headlight looks, because you want that owl looking straight at you. And I'm just feathering around the eyes a little bit with a knitting needle. And now these are just little, like, teardrop shapes, but I call them his eyebrows, but that's what makes him look like he's mean and glaring at you. When you do the eyebrows on people and animals, they can just change the expressions amazingly. Again, just feathering a little bit. Didn't like it, take it off, redo it. Got to tell you, I had some blueberries last night, and they are not sitting very well in my stomach. Which is odd, because blueberries never make me sick. Must have been a bad batch, but they tasted good. I love blueberries. Now, again, I should have put the hook in before I did the eyebrows and the eyes. But this is an older video before I learned my lesson. See, I'm learning also. One thing I always have to remind myself is when I put a beak on a bird and then I have a tendency to want to make a mouth with the needle tool, make a big smile, but no, they don't have a mouth, they have a beak. Like, don't you just want to put a big smile on him? No, he has a beak. Love those eyes. And of course, bake according to the instructions on your package of clay. And after I baked and cooled him, I added some white dots onto the branch and a dot in each eye. And there he is, all done. And I don't think he was that hard, but I think he came out pretty well. I like him. I hope you do too. And we'll see you next time. Please like and subscribe. Bye.